According to Facebook, the first human head transplant operation is scheduled for this year, December 2017. Doctors are going to move a healthy human head from a subject with an otherwise unhealthy body and move the head onto an otherwise healthy, brain-dead donor body. Isn't that crazy? But despite what you might have read, humanity is not actually that much closer to transplanting a human head onto a new body than we were last year. Sorry guys. The rumor of the first human head transplant, or more accurately, the first full body transplant, was started by Dr. Sergio Canavero, an Italian-Chinese neurosurgeon. He started making headlines a few years ago because he claimed that he'd found a technique for successfully amputating a person's head and regrafting it onto a healthy body. This technique involved making a very sharp incision in the spinal cord and placing the patient into a state of therapeutic hypothermia to allow the body to recover. But while this technique sounds cool, it's still a very long way from actually solving all of the technical problems of a head transplant. You see, to transplant a person's head, you'd have to sever and then reattach the spinal cord. A severed spinal cord usually means paralysis and death, so voluntarily severing someone's spinal cord and moving their head onto a completely different body and somehow reattaching it, that's gonna be difficult. You've also got massive arteries running through the neck, and not to mention shittones of muscle and bones and ligaments and tendons. A hair transplant's gonna be a massive operation, way massiver than the first successful face transplant, which happened last year. But whatever. Is a head transplant mission difficult or mission impossible? Well, Dr. Canavero has found a willing patient for the procedure, a guy called Valery Spinajov, a Russian man with Werdnig-Hoffmann disease, a form of spinal muscular atrophy. Dr. Canavero also has published papers on the technique, and he claims to have successfully transplanted a monkey's head. But unfortunately, no evidence has actually been released detailing that monkey head transplant. And his papers, whilst totally cool, we're about nerve regeneration in a patient that's had spinal injury, which is totally different to nerve transplants onto a completely different body. So sadly, a full head transplant procedure still has a lot of hurdles to jump over before it's actually possible, including how to keep the brain alive for hours without blood flow. It might be possible eventually, but that time, it's far away from this time. To me, the real question, my dear PsyQ viewers, is if a transplant were possible, would you want someone else's head on your body or someone else's body attached to your head? Let us know which one you'd prefer in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching PsyQ and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.